Welcome to Chapter 6, where we are going to spend some time looking at strings in a bit more detail. In particular, how to compare two strings. This is such an important topic that we're giving over a whole chapter to this, although it will be a short one. We are going to first of all see that there is a trap with string comparisons. It doesn't work exactly like you might expect it to, and we'll see how to correctly compare two strings. We can then learn how to do a switch statement using strings, and we'll finally look at the ternary operator. This can be thought of as a shorthand way of doing a certain type of if statement in Java. But first we need to look at strings, and I'm starting again from an empty main method. In the if and switch statements that we've looked at so far, we've been comparing the values of integers. There's a slight trap that might happen when we look at strings, so let's see what happens now. I'm going to start by declaring two strings with my name and the name of a friend of mine. We'll do string my name and set that equal to Matt Greencroft. I'm going to declare a second string. Let's call that one your name. And I'll set its value to Matt Bankside. Now, let's pull out the first names of these two people. So we'll create two more strings. I'll call the first one my first name. And I'll set that to my name.substring. I've just done control and space there because I couldn't remember whether the string bit of substring had a capital or not. So I wanted Eclipse to give me a little hint. And I want this second version. I'm saying we're starting at the position and we want to pull out four characters. I'll do the same thing with the second one. So string your first name equals your name dot substring 0 and 4. And then I'll just output both names to the console to check it looks correct. So we'll do system.out.println my first name and system.out.println your first name. And hopefully we'll get the name Matt printed out twice to the console. So let's try it and see. And we do. Now here's where things get a bit tricky when using an if statement. My first name and your first name both have the value Matt. So if we did an if statement that compared them, so if my first name equals equals your first name, we'd expect that to evaluate to true. So let's output if it does, system.out.println, we have the same name. And let's run this. And what we've seen is that we have the same name hasn't been output. In fact, just to prove that's definitely what's happening, let's stick an else in, and we'll put in our else, system.out.println, our names are different. And surprisingly, we get printed out, our names are different, and yet we can see they're the same. Now, the reason why this happens is slightly complicated, and we'll touch on it a bit later in the course. But for now, remember never to use equals equals with strings. Instead, strings have a function built in called equals, and you pass into it the second string. So we need to replace this with my first name dot equals your first name. And this will work like we wanted it to, and hopefully we'll now get back we have the same name. We have the same name. So just to recap, if you're comparing two strings, you need to use string one dot equals in brackets string 2 and not string 1 equals equals string 2. This is an important trap to be aware of because using this second format will normally compile and in some instances it will work as you expect, but not always. So there's nothing to hint to you that you might have made a mistake until your application is running, maybe many months after you've written it, and suddenly you start to get out values that weren't expected. Almost every programmer will at some point in life make this mistake, so just be careful to always remember when you're comparing strings, you must use the dot equals method. And a final point on the use of the switch statement is that you can only evaluate a string with a switch from Java 7 onwards. So if you're writing code that's going to run in Java 6, you can only switch on integers. The way to get around this is to revert back to using multiple if and else statements. One final point on if statements before we leave this section of the course is that Java provides a shorthand way of writing if statements known as the ternary operator. Now, although this looks quite confusing, it's worth getting to grips with how it works because a lot of Java programmers like to use it, if only to show off their prowess with the language. So let's have a quick look. And we're going to declare two variables. I'm going to call the first one I and set its value to 7. And I'm going to declare the second one j, but I'm not going to set its value straight away. I'm going to create an if statement that checks the value of I. So we'll do if I equals 7. And we'll set the value of j to 1. If I isn't 7, we'll set the value of j to 2. So we'll do else j equals 2. And let's just finish by printing out the value of j. So we'll do system.out.println j. And hopefully this is going to tell us j is 1. Let's try that and see. There we go. So the shorthand way of doing this is as follows. We're going to say j is equal to. Next, we're going to write our conditions. That's I equals 7, close brackets, followed by question mark. Then the value of j if that condition was true, which is going to be 1, a colon, and the value if it's false, which is going to be 2, and end with a semicolon. So the syntax here is our new variable is going to be set to this value if the condition is true, and this value if the condition is false. I like to think of this almost by reading it as an English sentence. Ask a question, question mark, yes or no. So again, going back to our code, we're saying, is I equal to 7? If it is, give us the value 1. If it isn't, give us the value 2. I'll just comment out my code here. And I'm going to use a little shortcut on Eclipse to do that, which is I'm going to highlight my code and then click on Control and forward slash. So we're just running our new piece of code here, and we'll run it to check j has still got the value of 1. And just to prove it works, I'll change I to 8, and then j should get the value of 2. And it does. Now in this example, I've used j as an integer. You're more commonly going to see this with strings. So we'd have, for example, a string called j, and we'd be saying, if I is 7, let's output I is 7. And if it isn't, we'll output I is not 7. And we can print out our j and let's run that. And we get a sensible looking answer. Well, that brings this short chapter on strings to a close. We first saw the trap that exists in Java when we want to compare two strings, and we learnt how to use the dot equals method to compare the value of strings correctly. We then went on to use strings as the basis for our conditions in a switch statement, and we finished by seeing the ternary operator, a shorthand way of writing a particular type of if statement. Well, we've now covered most of the basic Java syntax, and we are therefore ready to move on to look at a key topic for anyone learning Java, object orientation, and that's coming up in Chapter 7.